Hey, what up, it's your boy Saint, and thanks for being here. Beautiful, beautiful outdoors. I'm starting to love doing videos on my phone and just spontaneous like that, you know, and also outdoors. So, super nice. Breathing in a prana today, my nose is not so blocked. So, I was on my way home from work when someone jumped off the taxi that I was in, and then a child ran out from the house and gave them a beautiful hug, and I was like, wow, you know, that's so much love there, right? So much love. And then I thought about it a little bit further, and I was like, you know what, that's also appreciation for the mum or the caretaker, whoever that woman is, going to work in Maya. You know, you gotta appreciate the people that are out here working in Maya. You gotta appreciate the lives that people are living, the paths that people are taking. Oh yes, we're all up for that consciousness, right? We're all up for that realization and you know, awakening, in being enlightened. And but everybody's path is valid, and everybody's heading to the same place. Actually, everybody is already enlightened. Everybody's already source. So you gotta appreciate that. It's starting to rain. I'm gonna do this in the rain. Don't really matter. Oh, I feel so good out here. And I was saying to myself, we gotta appreciate us as source creators, the ones who've created Maya. We made it so hard for ourselves to awaken. So crazy. Or is it easy for us to awaken? It's just so crazy. Like, I've been going through so much emotions in the past couple of days. So much emotions. And I kept telling myself, you know, as much as I feel it, right? I'm feeling these emotions, but I kept telling myself, it's just an illusion. It's just an illusion. It's just an illusion. But yeah, this illusion feels so real. So, so hectic. We've made the game so hard. We've made the illusion so real. It's just so crazy. It's just so crazy. So I realized one thing. I realized that no matter how hard it is to awaken, or how hard it is to realize, you know, I realized how hard it is to realize. But no matter how hard it is, one thing we can do is what I was talking about the last time, which is step 3, surrender. Surrender to the emotions, surrender to the path, surrender to the human existence, the life. I'm not saying identify yourself as the body. No, I'm saying surrender to the human existence, right? Surrender to the human existence when or while knowing that you are source. You are the awareness behind all of that. So it makes Maya a little bit more easier, knowing that everything is in God's hands, and no matter how crazy it gets, all I need to do is just surrender, right? I just need to remember. I will keep that like an affirmation within myself that I am experiencing or being aware of the experiences. I am being aware of the experiences. Yeah? I blow my nose. It's not clogged, but I blow it. Like, I've been going through so much emotions. Sleepless nights. keep saying to myself, I'm sauce. I'm aware of these experiences. I'm aware of these emotions. It's all just an illusion. And as I said, we made it so hard. We made it so real that it's there and it's aching. You know, this the pain I cause other people is aching. You know, oh, it's their experience. It's my experience. You know, but you still cause pain to other people if you do crazy shit. You know. So I said to myself, you know, as much as I am the viewer or the awareness behind the experience, I'm just going to allow myself to feel the experience and still be aware that I'm the awareness behind the experience. It allows you to be more free. Just let go. Just let go. Feel everything. Go through everything. Know who you truly are, right? I think the sun's actually trying to come out. I let the sun come out. Yeah. Know who you truly are. And don't be like, I'm the awareness, right? This is just an illusion. And not allow yourself to feel it. Because you could snap it. But you're basically burying it, right? You're basically burying all the emotions, you're burying all the experiences because you're saying, nah, this is just an illusion. I'm not going to feel that. That's not real. No. Know that you are Source. Know that you are the awareness that is experiencing all these objects within this awareness. Know that you are the Absolute. You are God. And you came here to experience this life. You came here to awaken to yourself. The one who seeks is the one. What is it? The one who's seeking Source is Source. The one you're looking for is you. The one you're waiting for is you. So know that you are the Absolute, but also know that you as the Absolute made a choice to come down to this planet, to this dimension, and you knew exactly what you're going to go through, and it's okay to go through that. So don't cut it, don't bury it, go through it. But also carrying the cross, carrying the truth with you as you go through it. Ooh, that's so nice. I didn't even think of that. It's like all the suffering and everything. Jesus was actually carrying the cross, going through it, knowing who he truly is. So he's there pulling and struggling through the streets. There was actually a guy on the side who actually came and helped him as well, because he was just struggling, but he knew his Source, right? He knew his Source. He could have easily just said, done with this. But he had to do that. He surrendered to it, knowing that this is what I came for. This was the mission. This was my soul's mission. I came to go do this. For whatever reason, whether it's shedding, whether it's karma, whether it's whatever you want to think it is, that was the reason. So whatever you're going through, that's the reason that you gotta surrender to it. Because you might not see it now, right? But you gotta surrender to it. Alright, so I'm gonna close there. I'm gonna close there. I guess Maya is not that hard after all. And it's not that hard after all. As long as you're not causing resistance to it. I was watching a video recently and it was talking about a car. It was talking about something about fuel, right? It said, do you think you save fuel if you turn the AC off and you open the window? And the guy was like, yeah, you save fuel. And the guy who was asking him the question said, no, you don't save fuel. You actually use up more fuel. So he was like, what? And I was like, what? So he said, the car is designed, the aerodynamics of the car is designed, the cuts in the car, the way it's shaped is designed to cut through air, through the wind, you know, when you're driving. So it cuts through, it's smooth, and it allows your car to not use up so much energy or petrol or diesel or whatever it's running on. But as soon as you think, oh no, the AC is eating up all of that, let me put that off, open my window, you allow air to come in through the window and it starts to cause more friction with the air outside. So it actually makes your car use up more energy pushing through the air. So in other words, in turn, you use up more gas. Crazy, right? And that's the same thing we're talking about. You need to glide through this. You need to use every tool you got. Every tool you got. Every activation. Every gift. Everything. To soar through Gaia. Like an eagle. You need to soar through Gaia. Through Maya. You need to soar through it. Use it. Don't cause a friction, because friction causes suffering. Right? Friction causes suffering. Thank you so much for being here. It's just amazing. Just dropping these videos. Hit that bell so you don't miss out on anything. Subscribe first. Share this video, and may we all just wake up together, may we all just remember together, may we all just realize together, may we all just become that living embodiment of that God and walk in that, think like that. But I guess you probably won't have much thoughts anyway, right? You'll be in the now. I was going past, I went to the beach, alright, I went to the beach, y'all already know that. I went to the beach, and when I was coming back in the taxi, I saw such a powerful thing written in graffiti, not even styled nice and looking all glam and whatnot, just sprayed on the wall like, and it said, who really is listening? And I was blown away. Who really is listening? Just blew my mind. I mean, I could have been like a year ago or so, and I read that, it wouldn't have did anything for me. I would have just been like, oh, I wonder what that guy is talking about. Maybe he's talking about something social or whatever, like who's listening to him or whatever, or her. But it blew my mind now. Because I'm like, I'm the awareness behind this whole experience, right? So who's really listening? Who's really seeing? Who's really being, acting, living? Because the eye doesn't even exist. Thank you guys for being here. It's your boy. Oh, it's your boy Saint saying peace, love and light. Stay godly.